other. There's an endless road to rediscover.
Brothers, this is Cam here from Hey Brother Outdoors. Going to a new spot I've never scouted before, never hunted. Last year in North Carolina, I really only hunted a couple spots and I only was able to do it for maybe a month total. Last year, mostly I was in Georgia. This year is gonna be strictly North Carolina. I'm gonna talk to my friend, see if I can make a Georgia trip. It might be 4 days. That's for a future talk. As far as I'm tracking, I'm gonna do strictly North Carolina, so I'm trying to get as many spots as possible, scouting as many deer locations as possible, especially with my saddle this year. I'll be able to get out of a spot if it's not hot, and I can move to another spot with a lot of ease. Anyway, I'm going to the spot, and you guys will be able to see me gauge a spot based on just Google Maps, really. I drive by this area a lot, but I haven't actually gone in depth into it. Usually on a map, I'll look for the water, and that's where I'm gonna go first. I'm gonna go towards the water, and that's usually where you're gonna find rub lines, scrapes. Maybe right now they might be doing scrapes, just to kind of start their social habits. You have to be very cautious when you're hunting rub lines, because that buck may not be there at that time. Maybe early season. If you see fresh rubs early season, that's where I would most likely hunt rub lines. Later on in the year, I learned last year the hard way, don't hunt the rub lines later on in the year, especially after the rut. I would more try to find scrapes and food later on in the season. This spot doesn't have an open field near it. It's just thick forest. I've seen deer tracks on the trails when I run the trails out here. That's where I'm gonna start first, is the thick stuff. You gotta get into the thick stuff to see where they're at.
So I'm just walking this trail and hopefully I'm going up to another trail and I'm gonna dig into this spot. I'm just trying to get farther down the road because my first access point that I wanted to enter was not available. So I'm gonna use the trails to my advantage until I get to the next spot. I should have taken a video of me getting prepared. I have all the camera gear, my GoPro, this camera, thermocell on my hip. It's a lot. I didn't realize it was a lot. I'll keep going along here and make my way down to hopefully some good rub lines. Start with rubs. At least rubs tell me that's something in the area, and if there's fresh shavings, then that's definitely a good sign. So more to follow. So I just definitely bumped something that was down there in this thick, if you look down there, there's a lot of thick trees going on down there. I'm assuming it's some sort of drainage. If it's not water, it's definitely at least super thick. Maybe they were eating and I kind of came up here and I was moving. I wasn't going very fast, but definitely bumped. I mean, that thing was barreling out of here. I know the difference between a squirrel and a deer when a deer is running, okay? But when you're sitting there and deers are walking, you can't hear them. Okay, but when a deer runs, they barrel through the escape path, and his escape path, or her escape path, was definitely through the thick stuff. So I'm gonna go in, down there, see if I can find any sign of browse or possibly any rubs or footprints or anything like that. All right. Okay, so I made my way down to where I spooked that deer. I haven't gotten into the thick stuff yet, but there's so much oaks here. There's so much acorns here. This is definitely, like I said, if you find in North Carolina, if you find oaks and you find acorns, you found gold. And sure enough, that there was a deer here. And on top of that, this place is kind of a safe haven. It's fenced off. Nobody's coming in here because you got to get through a fence. So I'm gonna make my way down in there and see if we can find more oaks, which I guarantee you there's just acorns probably all the way down there, and that's probably what that deer was feeding on when I jumped it. So let's keep going. All right, so after making my way down where I spooked that deer, I ended up finding kind of a drainage off of obviously a main creek that's more this way. So this drainage is all, there's no water in it, but it's it did rain yesterday, like a lot, so it's very, very fresh, very muddy. I found an obvious crossing, a huge deer hoof print in there, so that would be something I might want to exploit. At least maybe putting a camera up there to see if deer use that kind of funnel as a crossing path over this, just so that they're not on the road. Or more like, I think I just spooked a deer that was grazing. I didn't see any buck sign, no rubs. I'm just at the kind of the transition line, if you will. This is probably the spot where I would hunt, because if I go any deeper in here, I'm going to make a lot of noise. So there's deer here, which is nice, because I thought there wasn't going to be deer here because it's a fenced off area. But where there's forest, there's deer. I'm not very far from the road over there, of course, but it is split between, there's a fence in between me and that hardball road over there. I'm gonna keep getting deeper in here and see if I can find some more sign. If there are just doe here, well then I'll still hunt the spot because I still want to get doe, especially early season. But if this is not a heavy deer area, I'll probably leave the doe here and a buck will find this doe. If she considers it safe, then she'll stay here and the buck will follow. So anyway, I'll keep getting into it. All right, y'all, I made it pretty far into this draw and there's just no sign. There's a lot of paths that they can take, but there's no obvious deer sign. I just want this to kind of be a lesson to everyone, like, get in there, get in the thick stuff, but if you don't see a deer sign off the bat, give it a little bit and try to find some, but then just back out and honestly just go up the creek more until you find some. So I'm gonna head my way back. All right, hunters, this is what you would consider the transition line. You can see behind me, it is super thick, right? That's where the draw starts, okay? And then as I turn around, you see it opens up. That's the transition line where it gets from super dense into a little bit more open. This is where I would probably set up more than likely. Back that way, or earlier, is where I came from, and that's where I saw them crossing. I saw hoof prints across the drainage. So that leads me to believe that they're traveling through this meadow. This is probably where I would start looking for trees and probably just go out here by that funnel where they were. I saw it wasn't just one hoof print. It was definitely two or three different crossings, and that was just today, right? In the last 24 hours, because it rained. So all that stuff is fresh. That's another thing about scouting. Also, make sure you're constantly checking yourself for ticks. I had one get right up to my neck and I flicked it off. I killed him. I'm gonna keep hunting or scouting. It's part of hunting. I just love being out here, man. Like, just being out here, embracing the suck. It's nice, right? Just look, don't get bogged down on one spot. There's deer out here. Just gotta find them. All right, this is what I was looking for. This is how they're getting in, all right? One track, but that's only because it just rained last night, but that is for sure sign. Because we have, that's the road that I parked off of that way. There's this water right here. They're gonna come in and they're gonna hug the cover, right? And then they're gonna walk the transition line. There are obvious trails in there that they use because they're just like us. They don't wanna walk through the tall stuff. They're gonna go where there's obvious trail. And then just as super quietly as I can, just get right in there. Maybe 30 meters in, you don't have to, I know I don't have to go very far because this is the fatal funnel. This is where they're coming in. It's super easy to cross. That's my plan for at least this spot. There's more spots within this area I want to check out, but I mean, that's a good spot and I can still make it to work. I also wanted to reiterate that once you find kind of the area that you think you're going to hunt, make sure you go mark it on either hunt stand or if you have Onyx, mark it on your Onyx app. I was about to say on here, you know, I'm skeptic. I don't know, they're probably doing this at night, but I just bumped a deer not less than 100 yards from here. They're coming from that side of the road, coming over here to feed right now. That's what their pattern is right now. It was about 5 o'clock when I bumped that deer. I think I'm gonna go back down there, mark my tree. Don't let anything deter you from continuing mission. This is definitely hunting area. This is definitely deer sign. It may not be a huge amount of deer sign like you see on other YouTube channels where they just go to a field and there's like 20 deer out there. I wish that was the case over here. You can't go in somewhere where it's super loud and be like, yeah, this is the great spot. You're gonna bust all the deer, right? You gotta find that spot that's in between the bedding areas where they're eating, drinking, and whatnot. And you just gotta hope and a prayer, right? You set up in a tree and hope and a prayer. All right, I'm gonna make my way back this way, get to my truck, and I will see you guys later. Don't forget to like, share, subscribe. All right, and don't forget, take your brother hunting. All right, out here.